Shalom, this is the brother Azana Moth back at you with another lesson. And I pray this lesson is edifying to the lambs, to the sheep of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekahakwadash, and double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who do it well. Peace and salutations to the house of David, the Bayasha Dawada, right in a large multitude. And see, why do bad things happen to quote unquote good people? People say God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. That's the saying in the Christian church. That's the saying in reality. But consider the works of the Lord. I found out being in His truth, He's not good all the time. He's a balanced power that kills and makes alive. Was He good when He drowned the Egyptians? How about when He flooded the earth and all the beasts thereof? How about when He opened up the earth and swallowed people? Was He good when He put my father to death? Put my brother to death at 17 years old? Was He good then? You see, how can we not respect the power that can cancel us in a split second? So I'm telling the story of a brother that heard this truth and went the other direction. And then the Lord put a plague on him, right? He can bring you into perils. And it's like the last four or five lessons, the Lord's been taking me down this same street, showing Israelites that want to walk in their own way, turning their ears from the words of the Heavenly Father. Let's not get it twisted. You can be the man one day, living life without any worries. You know, you can be a decent man in the community, minding your own business, going to work on your 9 to 5. You know, not necessarily even a wicked man. But when it's all over, would you look back and have any regrets? Will you think back in retrospect and would have done something different? And I'll tell you firsthand, none of us are perfect. We all fall short. Let's get that in the book of Romans, the 3rd chapter. This is Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and have come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Right, we are redeemed through believing in Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. But what about the others? The essentials and the pleasures of life. You know, being a good co-worker, a good citizen in your community. You feed the needy when you can. But if you don't serve the Lord, He can still put you in a situation like this. Or even worse, put you to death, which is reflected to being justified by His grace. See, once you come across a video from a man of the Lord or saw brothers at camp, you stand there, you listen, it sinks in, it makes sense. But you struggle to turn from what you followed your whole life to a truth that you just heard of. See, that's a conflict of interest with the Lord, because you've been spiritually marked now. And if any man love the world, the love of the Most High is not him. So why would the Lord care? This is Proverbs 13:13. Whoso despiseth the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. And we're looking for rewards out here. It said whoso, meaning whosoever can get it. And that starts with me first. But He can also set you free from the prison of a plague body. Like this situation right here, this brother got cancer, leukemia. Okay? What's more important than your health? This is Sirach 30:15. Health and good estate of body are above all gold, and a strong body above infinite wealth. You can have infinite wealth. You can have all the money in the world, but what's it worth if the estate of your body is breaking down to the point where it collapses on you from your indulgence of cigarettes, alcoholism, you know, drugs? That shit catches up. Instead of a sound body, you're on dialysis. daily blood treatments. All your joy has turned into mirth. So I ask again, was it worth it? Was it worth it? The scriptures say death is better than to live like this. Right? This is Sirach 30:16. There is no riches above a sound body, and no joy above the joy of the heart. Death is better than a bitter life or a continual sickness. So we need mercy. We need grace and healing. Because the Lord has the power, and He wants obedience. He can give you relief from your physical pains and sleepless nights where your thoughts are consumed in worries. He has the power and authority to give you peace from the flesh that wants to take over the spirit. Right? Prayer, fasting, and tithing is a hell of a combination. And having faith, the belief of the report. But if you continue to feed your flesh and put off the Most High and His Son, He can bound you with diseases like cancer, tumors that bring in pain that you can't imagine. Okay, some of your family members may experience some of this stuff, right? He can do it fast or He can do it slow. Remember the plagues He put on the Egyptians in Egypt. What about the plague He put on King Jehoram? He was a wicked king, and he led Israelites to praise pagan gods. He had them worshiping deities, and the Lord struck them with an incurable intestinal disease. Hey, you don't want to fall in the hands of the Most High. This is what happened to King Jehoram. The Lord struck this man and made his bowels come out. You want to play with a God like that? This is 2 Chronicles 21:15. And thou shalt have great sickness by disease of thy bowels, until thy bowels fall out by reason of the sickness day by day. So the Lord tortured this man. He was in torments, day by day, in pains like you can't imagine. You see, the Most High is slow to anger. He has compassion, He's patient. But we can't take that for granted, because He's a man of war. He's the King of terrors. He killed a king of Jerusalem, and you think we're untouchable? This is 2 Chronicles 21:18. And after all this, the Lord Yahweh smote him, his bowels, with the incurable disease. And this brother that we're using, I'm not going to say his name, but he had no worries. He heard the word, and now he's fighting for his life, battling cancer, with a tube over your mouth every morning. Everything was all good just a week ago. Before your eyes witnessed, and you heard the voice of the Lord and rejected it. Look at these videos and epistles that we continue to bring out, broaden out this point. Okay, a brother could have been sincere and read to you 1 Corinthians 11:4, that it's a shame for a man to have long hair. Okay, and sometimes it's something that simple that Jake resents and Jake doesn't want to hear. Something that simple. So you rebuke the messengers, and when you do that, you rebuke the one who sent the message. Therefore, because you turned your face from the Lord, what did the Lord do in return? He made all your hair fall out, completely bald. Jake, you gotta wake up. You gotta wake up, Jake. The Lord is working, and He's showing His power in these last days. This is Proverbs 13:14. The law of the wise is in the fountain of life, to depart from the snares of death. That's right, the table of snares is set before us all. But the wise will take heed to find the fountain of life, and that's through the Heavenly Father. But the despised, uncertainties will follow you all the days of your life, lest you repent. And as the days are getting closer to Jacob's trouble, and the insurrections of Esau's wrath comes down, we're bringing out these videos of repentance. And you can't repent to idols and false gods of these Babylonians. No, we repent by asking the God of Israel to forgive us and have mercy on us. You see, because a lot of you that know the name, you still pray to Jesus. You still pray to your Allah. And your prayers aren't being heard. This is Proverbs 28:9. He that turns away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayers shall be an abomination. So even your prayers are an abomination if it's not directed to Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. The Lord is striking Israelites down daily. Yahweh, he's all-knowing and all-powerful. Allah Shatya, okay? He's the king of terrors, demon-like power. He's to be feared. He's to be referenced. Again, you can have the greatest life going for yourself, and in a moment, you're cursed, plagued with demons. I personally feel that if I ever stop teaching, if I ever stop serving the Lord, he's going to put me to death. I have a fear that he will let my sins overwhelm me. And I'm afraid of that. We have to have a true sense of the fear of the Lord. And he's showing you why. And for you so-called prophets that lose patience and switch up the doctrine to the point where they don't go out no more, well, the Lord eventually purges them out of this truth. We've seen this happen. Well, just like this young man is fighting for his life. You quit, they quit, and this man right here turned his face. And both were never fit for the purpose of the kingdom. Right? That's Luke 9:62. Let's get that. It says, and Yahweh Shai said unto him, no man having put his hand to the plow and looking back, it's fit for the kingdom of God. Okay? It's imperative once you come across this word, this truth. The angels are marking you. This is serious, man. You see what happened to Lot's wife, of a spirit that didn't believe. Martin Luther King on his last speech said, he has seen the mountaintop, and his eyes have seen the glory of the Lord. So in closing, there is no looking back. Once you've seen and heard the message of the God of Israel, Yahweh, you have to reap what you sow if you choose to do it your way. Epistle after epistle after epistle, we're showing you that you have to fear the Lord. Just repent. We all have to prepare mentally for the darker days that are coming. We ain't seen nothing yet. And you don't want this for yourselves. You don't want the Lord to put ailments on you and having anxieties that you can't get over. Use the power of prayer and do it without ceasing. And you will find comfort in Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. And with that, I give all honor and glory to my Heavenly Father, Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem Rakahak Wadash. This is the brother Azan Ha'amoth. I pray this lesson was edifying. Wa Ababa Bo. Shalom.